We've talked about root escalation vulnerabilities, both local and remote, the remote ones being considerably worse. We've talked about memory leaks in the Cosmic Desktop. We've talked about malicious developers who are probably state-funded actors taking over critical pieces of infrastructure in the Linux world. And we've talked about the questionable intentions behind the mass deployment of AI utilities and all manner of other incredibly serious bugs and issues in the Linux world and beyond. But today, we must talk about the most serious and the most important issue that you will ever see. Believe me, there is nothing that is a more serious problem than what we are talking about today. A problem that is found present in a very important Linux distro, the biggest distro in the world, Ubuntu, specifically 24.10 Oracular Oriole. Random side tangent, I had no idea what oracular meant. Apparently it means relating to an oracle or hard to interpret, enigmatic. I think they need to put the thesaurus away and just come up with a normal name for Ubuntu. Now, most people know about the default Ubuntu wallpaper. For most of the versions, and especially the more modern versions, it is a stylized version of the animal in their name. So in Jammy Jellyfish 22.04, it was a jellyfish. In 18.04, it was a beaver. And in 24.010, it is an oriole. Now, in my opinion, this is not my favorite default Ubuntu wallpaper, but it's certainly not a bad one. I like it. It's fine. But they also include some supplementary images. Now, some of them I actually really like. I would run this on my personal system, and I might actually have to extract it out of the ISO and go and do so. Also, because this is the 20th anniversary of Warty Warthog, there is an anniversary wallpaper as well. But we don't care about those, and we don't care about the default either. What we care about are the supplementary images of the animal in the name, the oriole. This is a bird. Here is a picture of it. Here is another one. As you can tell, an oriole is a tiny species of bird. Now, some of them are bright and colorful, like the Baltimore oriole, and others are a lot more muted in colors, like the olive-backed oriole. Now, the problem is Canonical has made a very, very grave mistake. A mistake that I don't think can ever be forgiven. Under the appearance settings, we are not able to see the names of the images. It just shows the image, and then we can go and click on them. However, let's check where they are located on the file system. Under /user/share/backgrounds, here are the wallpapers. Here is the 3D art one, and here is the actual picture. Oriole by Julian Tomasini, and this one is Oriole 3D by Dillip. Now, don't get me wrong, this is a great picture, and the other one is great 3D art. The only problem is they're not actually pictures of orioles, of any species, at all. They are birds, clearly they're birds, but they're not orioles. Try as you might, you will never find an oriole that looks like this bird, because this is a bullfinch, specifically a Eurasian bullfinch. This was also corroborated by Joey Sneddon over on OMG Ubuntu. Ubuntu? That's a bullfinch, not an oriole. He did a search with the Google Lens, and it turns out it was the wrong bird. This wallpaper led to the creation of the most important bug report you will ever see. Wallpaper Shows the Wrong Bird, made by Abaddon Grellis, which has a lot of Ubuntu bug report boilerplate, including my favorite part, the CPU info and the environ, which have literally nothing to do with the issue at hand here. Knowing we have the fish shell and xterm doesn't really change much. The only part of the report that actually matters are points 3 and 4. When I choose the wallpaper, /user/share/backgrounds/oriole by Julian Tomasini, there should be an oriole shown on the desktop. Instead of an oriole, the wallpaper displays a bullfinch, a different species of bird. Now, being a bug that affects at least 11 people, that is an understatement. This bug affects everybody. The status was changed to confirmed. This super important bug could have just been ignored, could have just been left up to users to go and fix themselves or users to go and suffer. But thankfully there is someone in here who actually cares to fix the problem, Ian Griffin, who made a pull request. And when he was doing so, he noticed there wasn't just a single instance of there being a problem. There were actually multiple places referring to the bird by the wrong name. Now, he hasn't actually gone and fixed all of them because the 3D image is still called an Oriole and it's still not an Oriole. So while we are seeing the Julian Tomasini image being addressed across the author's file, across the file itself, the JPEG, and across an XML file, hopefully the rest of this issue can be addressed to make sure we are referring to the correct birds by the correct name. If Canonical had never fired their resident ornithologist, this problem never would have happened. This problem would have been dealt with before it ever shipped out to users and before everybody was left to suffer. But you know what? Maybe it's for the best, because maybe now we can actually be honest about what birds are. Birds are not real. Birds are fake. Birds were real at one point, but have all gone completely extinct. They have been replaced with government drones to spy on the world's population. Why do you think birds like to hang out on power lines? Do you think they just find it comfortable there? Have you ever stood on a wire? That's not comfortable. The reason why they are there is because they have induction charging pads on their feet. That is how the drones are charged. You know, they're like your smartphone. They have those nice little induction charging pads on the bottom and magically wirelessly charged with the electricity. Why do you think seagulls and pigeons are always hanging around people? Have you ever been around a wild animal? They don't like people. They will either attack you or they will run away. Seagulls and pigeons, though, no. They stay around you all the time. Now, the convenient cover story is they just want to steal your food. No, they want to be very close to you so you can talk into the microphone. Open your eyes, sheeple. Birds aren't real.
If you like the video, go like the video. I don't know why I made this. I genuinely could not tell you. But we're here anyway.
Yeah, if you like video, really like video, you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe, silly Burpee, link in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and
stay away from the birds.